So one of the gigs that Steve and I first went to when we met was their Nirvana show at the OK Hotel.
Oh, nice.
While Alice in Chains was across the street,
yeah,
filming the thing, and you were there.
Did you see me there?
I saw you there.
I was there.
You were standing behind the little backstage, because at the time, backstage, like,
okay,
it wouldn't have mattered.
Do you want to hear that story?
Yes.
My buddy, Mike Slater, one of my best friends in the world, he would, he'd always, like, drive me to gigs. Like, you know, I had a truck and everything, and I could drive myself, but he always wanted to come to gigs with me. So we heard about this OK Hotel show with Nirvana, with Dave, you know, like, I think one of his second or third show here in Seattle with Nirvana. Maybe it was his first show here with Nirvana, I don't know.
Maybe.
But anyways, so we went to the back, we went to the alleyway, you know,
yeah,
behind the OK, and knocked on the door, and Chris was there, so he let us in. And yeah, so we got to watch the whole set from the side there. And there's one point where Kurt, I didn't really know him that well, but I, you know, we were definitely familiar and acquaintances and stuff, but he broke his guitar string, and he handed me the guitar, and he's like, change my guitar string. and so there was a lunchbox, like a, you know, like a Scooby-Doo lunchbox with like just some like wrapped up strings. I don't know what string I was supposed to change, but so I started to change his string. It's like, okay, I don't know what string goes on which thing here. Somebody came in and kind of like finished the job for me, but I luckily,
calmer mind. Yes.
But it's cool. Like, he just gave me the guitar, change my string. Gladly, sir.
What right. else can I do?
My pleasure.
A latte, perhaps?
My pleasure.
Right.
It was an honor. Yeah. Oh my God.
Did you, had you seen Nirvana pre Dave?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Okay.
For sure.
So was,
for
and,
sure.
And did you know Dave?
No. I mean, I just met him through Nirvana. Chris introduced me when they played the Off Ramp. Like, that was the first, or maybe it was the first or second, I don't know.
Yeah.
First or second time I saw them with Dave. Yeah. So I wasn't really aware of his pre Nirvana stuff, but you know, Buzz has a great part in all of that as well. You know, he recommended Dave.
That was his work?
To Kurt. Yeah.
Yeah.
So Buzz plays a huge role in all of our careers.
Yeah. What role did he play in yours?
Oh, just, you know, just kind of support, and just, you know, like, we hung out. We loved the Melvins. Absolutely loved them. We didn't play too many shows with them, but when we did, it was always just fucking awesome. And they're just great dudes, man. I was at that Nirvana show, and I remember one other really good memory is, like, I was watching Dave play, and I was just amazed at his fucking power, just like how fucking like tight he was, and the tempos were spot on. But he had this fucking like disgusting like water pitcher, like a plastic water pitcher that was like right next to his left foot, and it was just like, there's all this like drumstick sawdust in it, and it just, like, the container was like really dirty, and he had these like disgusting hiking socks, like like wool hiking socks, and he think he had like Converse on. It was like, that's the worst combination for drumming shoes I've ever seen in my life. But he would just like fucking pound, and he'd like drink this disgusting sawdust water, and I was just like,
whoa, he would. Oh,
that's
he
East
was
Coast punk rocker.
He was drinking.
These guys are bros, man.
He was drinking the.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, that's all there was, you know.
Right.
So it's like, you know, yeah. So that was a memorable moment. But they were always like great. They were always like great guy. At the Vogue, there used to be local music Wednesdays or
Tuesdays.
I think it was. So
yeah.
I remember seeing those guys at a Tuesday Vogue show with Chad and everything, and Kim and I were there, and you know, Kurt came up and introduced himself and everything, because we heard Love Buzz and we fucking loved it. So we hooked up with those guys
right
early on, for sure. Yeah. I think there's a photo of Kurt with a Soundgarden sticker on his guitar.
Perfect.
He loved, I heard that he really loved Screaming Life.
Yeah.
He really loved our first album, so that's cool. We played one show with them, and we only played one show in Olympia with Nirvana at the park. There's like a park down there in Olympia. And they opened for us, and there was no lights. It was just like this outdoor generator kind of deal, you know? And so they played like at dusk, and then we played like past dusk, and it was just like, okay, no lights, cool. Like, so we just kept playing.
Like no lights, but it's dark out, and yeah, you're like, it's like, yeah.
People were digging it. But at that time, Chad had a North drum set.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he had the North drums, which... Fucking, I loved those drums.
Great look.
That's another story, sidebar I can get into. But one of my fondest memories of that show is that Chris bought a box of Kentucky Fried Chicken, and he put it in one of the North tom-toms that like come out like that.
Uh-huh.
So he put the box of chicken in the drum, and between songs he's going there and like, have some chicken.
Brought catering right on stage.